Mingbo Taxi Industry Should Rise to the Challenge 2015年7月13日英文 A26 Editorial Mobile Applications Apps that provide transportation services with private cars or vans are now being condemned by the taxi industry. It is demanding that the authorities enforce the law strictly and crack down on illegal passenger transportation services. The taxi industry's reactions are completely normal and understandable, since apps like Uber and GoGoVan have indeed impacted on its operation. However, there is an irreversible trend towards digital platforms being employed in all industries. The taxi industry cannot but be affected. It may want the government to protect its interests. However, unless it seizes the opportunity to renew itself, it will be faced with even dearer challenges. It is years since apps providing passenger transportation services came into existence in regions around Hong Kong and other parts of the world. In this respect, Hong Kong has lagged behind. Services provided by means of such apps represent a direct challenge to conventional vehicles for hire, especially taxis. In other countries and regions, these apps have drawn fire and are a target of traditional industries' boycotts and legal actions. Though they have met with resistance of all kinds, these mobile apps have grown rapidly. They are now a component of the new economy. Recently, taxi operators in Hong Kong have conducted a slow drive protest against what they call pack pays. Their representatives have attended a Legislative Council public hearing in Black to express their dissatisfaction. They demand that the government crack down on illegal car hire services. Needless to say, the Transport Department cannot possibly rule out law enforcement, but on the other hand, the authorities do not seem to be about to target those apps. In fact, despite taxi operators' protests, citizens have not been repelled by app transportation services. On the contrary, such services seem to be getting a good reception from even more people. This goes to show the taxi industry has failed to win citizens' support for its campaign against pack pays. Why is that the case? It has to do with poor taxi services, with which most citizens are unhappy. Whenever it comes to taxi rides, many get hot under the collar. In the busy downtown area, most taxis in sight are out of service on rainy days. In particular, taxis that are not taking parade, as it were, along the street one after another, while citizens on the pavement are like cats on a hard tin roof. That is what many have experienced and are angry at. Taxi drivers refuse to take passengers for various peculiar reasons. Some are unwilling to go for long rides, while others do not want short ones. Some are reluctant to do rides that may make them go or their shifts late. To put it simply, there are myriad reasons why a taxi is not for hire. Having made their voices heard, taxi operators should now think about the industry's future. Can the industry enjoy prosperity forever simply by preserving the system that limits the number of taxi licenses? The answer is a definite no. Unless it enhances itself, shakes itself up and improves its services to make citizens feel taxi rides are good value for money, taxis will be shunned by citizens and other means of transport will take their place. In this light, a comprehensive reform should be the industry's top priority. Furthermore, the use of apps to facilitate passenger transportation is not rocket science. The industry should not sit on its laurels. It should dance with the advancements in modern technology and seek to renew itself in order to increase its worth.
的士业需自我提升，有破有立应对挑战。的士业者声讨有手机应用程式 App 以私家车或客货车经营载客生意，要求当局严格执法，制止非法载客泛滥。Uber、 GoGoVan 等 apps 运作，对的士营运确实带来影响，业界的反应完全正常和可以理解。不过，数码平台介入各行各业已经不可逆转，的士业也不能幸免。业界要求政府保障其利益之余，若不顺势求变， 最终只会迎来更大挑战。以手机 App 提供载客服务， 多年前在世界各地和本港周边地区已经出现，相对而言本港属于滞后 App 载客服务，实际上挑战传统出租车，特别是的士业，在其他国家地区都是野火油物，备受传统产业抵制甚或诉诸法律行动。即使面对种种反抗，手机 App 载客服务仍然快速壮大，已经晋身新经济其中一环。本港的士业界近期曾经以万洗声讨他们口中的白牌车，业界代表出席立法会公听会时穿上黑衣表达不满，要求政府严打非法载客取酬等。运输署当然不能排除会执法，不过也反映当局没有特别针对 App 载客服务之意。事实上，业界连串声讨行动之后，市民对 App 载客服务不单未抗拒，反而有更多人认同之势，这说明的士业界未争取到市民支持打击白牌车。缘何至此？这是与的士业服务水准低落，市民大多不满意有关。现在提起乘搭的士，许多市民都会一吐气。在市区闹市，举目所见的士大多按期拒绝载客，特别是在天雨日子，一辆接一辆空载的士招摇过市。马路两旁候车市民则宛如热窝上蚂蚁，这种场景许多人经历过，同表愤怒。部分的士司机这样做各有不同理由，包括嫌车程远不去，车程近亦不去，影响交更也不去，总之是猪般不去。的士业界表达不满之后，应该反思业界前景是否维护后空 B 的士牌照制度，就可以千秋万世永续久享。答案肯定 Auden V 不是。若的士业不肯自我提升，整顿队伍，提高服务水准，让市民认为乘搭的士的开支物有所值，即的士服务最终还是会被唾弃，由其他交通工具取代。因此，全面整治的士业是业界首要检讨和推动的工作。另外， App 载客服务并非什么深奥原理，的士业不能固步自封，要与现代科技共舞，寻求大变身，蜕变为更有价值的产业。
Glycerage at heart under the collar become angry like cats on a hot tin roof, so nervous or anxious that you cannot keep still or keep your attention on one thing, sit on its laurels. L. Be satisfied with what you have achieved and therefore stop trying to achieve anything new. 英语社评星档 English. Dot Ming Plow. Dot com. 车线 Critic. HTML